because then that puts the whole equity in a, in a, you know, in a comprehensive framework for company behavior. But I think it's interesting to see there are so many nuances. So, for example, a company that is that invests in farmers, but the farmers are part of their supply chain. Would that be considered as CSR, or would that be considered as part of business? I think there are a lot of questions like this. And I think it would be interesting to see, and one would hope that the new framers sort of keep that energy sort of thought in mind while trying to do this. Because the way I see it, for example, is that if you allow investments in improving farmer productivity as part of the 2%, and the companies see a benefit for their own supply chain by doing that, I think it's a classic win. The company benefits the farmer.
Sustainable.
It's exactly. Yeah. Then it just becomes, it remains, you know, sustainable. Now, I think that if those kinds of things are incorporated into the rules, it would really go a long way in making this 2% really significant and ensure that it happens. Because one obviously doesn't want a system, a situation where companies gain, you know, and say that, you know, they are asked to do this, so they do something. Because you see, at the end of the day, the question, I mean, the thing also is that you've got to remember that 2%, first of all, it's not, nobody, you know, it's not mandated.
Yeah, it is not mandatory.
It's endeavor to spend.
Yeah, yeah.
But then there is spend or explain, report and explain.
Yeah.
So you just push companies. Now, you don't want to report under spend. So you might gain, which would be sad. Secondly, it doesn't say anything about impact. It only tells you about impact. So you could spend 2% and have no impact.
Yes.
But if you create a business case for it, then it also, it's in the company's interest to ensure that the 2% gets spent in the manner that they impact them.
Yes.
So, at the end of the day, the basic, let's say, the basic motivation for a government is not that they need more companies to spend 2%, but they want it to have an impact.
Yes.
Right? So, I think that's really the question that the rules need to grapple with. How do we make sure that it gets spent in a manner that is impactful? I think the real some of the questions that sort of made, and it's interesting to see, because I think the rules will determine whether this is a step backwards or a step forward.
For example, if Indian multinational 60-70% of its revenue is coming from abroad, will they have to put 2% on the Indian money that they generate or the overall money that they generate? The cost of persons, the people's salary, will that be included or not included?
Exactly.
There is no clarity on all of these issues. What can be the loopholes? How can companies maneuver?
Well, I mean, you know, one of the questions that, again, people are asking is that can this be the form of a grant to a foundation? Will that be allowed? Now,
your own foundation, corporate foundation.
And then, you know, you can do whatever you want in that foundation. I mean, in the sense that you could do, you could spend the money, but have no impact. It's more difficult to do that when you say a grant to an NGO, you know, because you're not the only donor. You will end up doing something impactful. Your own foundation may not. So that could be some of the things that we need to be careful about. Because at the end of the day, the rules have to ensure that there's impact. Because that's the clear agenda.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it doesn't make sense.
Anything else?
No, I don't think there is